It is the Miscellaneous Podcast.
You are not bringing that thing in here.
I'm your host, Pauly, and today in our Miscellaneous Misfits, we have Aaron.
It wasn't me. It was the one-armed man.
We have B-Dism.
Chicken.
We have Travis.
What's good?
Frasley.
Hello.
And Norco Killer.
Say what?
With a title that says it all.
Shut up and sit down, you big bald fuck.
Let's get to it. Follow along with us in Discord. You can find the link at the bottom of the show notes. Chat with us. See all the stuff that we post in there. The stupid pictures, videos, etc. Come on, it's the Miscellaneous Podcast. I mean, this is the place where we store rakes. So,
rape?
No, rakes.
Are we raping? What movie was that from?
I think that was Blazing Saddles.
No, it's
he says, we're into rape, arson, rape.
Hot Tub Time Machine.
Hot
Tub Time Machine. He goes, are we raping? I don't know. Are we raping?
Oh.
I want to know what was in that damn box that said Cincinnati on it. Hot Tub Time Machine.
Mm-hmm.
Great White Buffalo.
Yes.
Wow.
You want to show us around your new place?
Let's put this pornography away.
Are we streaming? Because that was funny.
Not yet.
Oh, nice. Yeah. No, not yet.
You still recorded it.
I don't know how to show on.
No,
here.
I meant just up or down. Like, can you go down because we see like your desk and stuff? I don't want to see your whole damn room.
Oh no, I don't want to take it down because I've got monitors and stuff. So.
Oh, okay.
I want to see all over. I want to see like inside your drawers, closets. Go in your food pantry. Show me what you got in there.
Welcome to MTV Cribs Frasley Edition.
Hey, I just
my stuff.
That's fucking funny.
Hey, guess what? I got a new follower.
Yeah.
Yeah, Remax is following me now.
Nice. Hey, B-Dism.
Eureka and Wildwood.
Yo.
Awesome, Remax. Because today is the day that we choose.
Yeah, we might want to talk about that before we start. Like, actually,
what
recording.
Do you want to talk about?
Well, I have 12 followers. One of them's.
Do you want to push this one more month?
This is Remax, the real estate company?
Yep, of Eureka and Wildwood.
Oh,
and,
they want the stuff.
Yeah, they want the
now,
stuff.
Do you have a chair in case you want to sit down?
Yes.
Okay.
So then we got Frasley, and then we have the subsidiary of Frasley, Frazzlecast.
And I don't need to win, so.
No.
We have the true.
You do what I do.
The true Donnie G. Miscellaneous Podcast. Crab Boy, which is our dear friend, Baby Doll. Jody the Great Woods. Renika, another dear friend of the show. Zafira, friend of the show. Chris, Billiard Guy, friend of the show. And then we have two. One guy's name is Dave that I'm not so sure didn't just message me because I hashtagged giveaway. I don't know if he actually listened to the show or not. I've never seen anything else from him, but his name is...
Well, the friends of the show are okay to win, just not Dave. Actual co-hosts.
No, save on shipping.
They've all been on the show at Dave 928.
Who's been on the okay?
667.
We can't use exotic deodorant. Can't use baby doll. Okay.
I'd say Zeph's fine to win.
Is fine to win. The true Donny G is okay to win because he was only on for a couple things. Renika, she's okay to win. It's just like the people who are constantly on the show, no. Like any of our core group, no.
But are we randomizing it? Or here was what I was going to say. We have one true fan who watches us in the Twitter, in the Twitch, who I am certain followed us because he listened to us plead for.
And well, if name. You do, you want to choose. You no, choose.
You get to choose. You get to choose. But I don't know how else you wouldn't choose this guy because we know he listens and he followed because he listens.
Man,
and that is Twirl of 1020, Christopher.
Oh, I was thinking Telluride.
At Nightshade, who?
I tell him right, or did he? Because he was in chat, but you're right. I don't think tell him right.
I haven't seen the other one. He hasn't. He didn't follow. Well, but in all the stuff I listen to online, millions of times you hear people say like and follow and do it. I never do it. So
yeah,
I hardly blame people.
Okay, so here's. Are we streaming yet?
Not yet. Let me know when.
Yeah, do it now.
Okay,
we'll do it live.
Doing it now.
We'll do it live. Fuck it.
Travis, I have a shadowed figure in the Twitch.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Wait, are we doing the video with him in it?
Yeah, we're doing video, but I've got Norco as a shadowy figure. That was the only footage we have of Norco Killer.
Oh yeah.
Oh, sick.
I look like the guy from The Outsider. If you haven't started watching that on HBO, I recommend.
So it's on Twitch?
On Twitch, yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Where's the Twitch link so I can see your beautiful faces?
Oh, I got it. It's coming right at you.
Coming straight at you.
Coming right on your face.
Show me that.
Man, it's weird. You can still see like all my swollenness right here from the tooth.
Nice.
I get on camera if I cut my hair, but my hair is pretty bad right now.
It looks like you got injections, Paul.
Yeah. He got thick.
Youthful.
No, I if you look, these two teeth here have been completely redone.
Ow.
Yep. $2,000 later.
They look shiny.
Thanks.
Yeah. Shiny teeth.
Weird.
Makes me happy. Under the painkillers. Makes me feel fine.
Well, it's funny.
I'll trade you two Adderall for an Oxy.
2-for-1 sale.
Yeah.
Nice.
All right. So, I don't want to get started in this. I want to talk about some things real quick. So first, I was talking a little bit earlier about the Super Bowl. My team lost. And, yeah. Thank you for your sympathies. But I was really happy. It was great. It was great. I enjoyed the game at the very end. I slept through the most of it. But the commercials I really liked this year.
New ideas. Go.
Travel size bread.
Sparkle bread. Bread insurance.
Magnetic bread.
Hey, I'm going to need you to... Never mind.
I'll get both.
I don't know where we parked. I was following you.
Pizza, barbecue, and jalapeno.
Look at these two troublemakers.
Hey, Johnny, how are you?
Wicked cow. Is that new?
Make your move, cowboy.
I got the horses in the bag.
Yeah.
What is happening?
Here's Mountain Dew Zero.
I am thirsty.
Because yes. They've been really shitty for the last several years, and I was really happy they changed. How about everybody else?
Oh, yeah. Bill Murray with a Jeep recreating Groundhog Day.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. And fun fact, did you know that the mayor in Groundhog Day is Bill Murray's brother?
Brother. Yes, brother.
Yeah,
oh,
really?
Brian Doyle Murphy.
I like how we can't get him to redo fucking Ghostbusters, but he'll redo that fucking movie.
No,
I know.
Ben Aykroyd will do Ghostbusters anytime they ever need Ghostbusters. Dan Aykroyd's there.
Yeah, well,
yeah.
It's too
yeah. Well,
Egon's dead. Thanks.
Yeah, so we get him and we get
Ernie Hudson.
Yeah, Ernie Hudson. God, I was getting ready to say his what is it? Winston? Wasn't that his name?
Yeah.
Maybe the dead all rising.
That's a big Twinkie.
Great,
but yeah, a lot of the commercials are related. My favorite was, never mind. I got to retract that. I had a lot of favorites. One of them was The Shining with the guy from Breaking Bad. That was awesome.
Bryan Cranston. Yeah.
That was really cool.
Well, Bryan Cranston was first started on Malcolm in the Middle.
Mm-hmm.
It was one of his first roles when he was mainstream. Yeah, he played the dad on Malcolm in the Middle.
There had to be something else he was in before that, because I've seen him before. Like maybe bit roles here or there, maybe.
Yeah, I think he's been.
Roles, yeah. He's been in a lot of stuff.
I think he's been in a couple movies, too.
Yeah, that's why I remember seeing him like in maybe 90s movies as like the background guy.
Yeah. I wouldn't doubt it.
But yeah, Malcolm in the Middle was his first like major one, I guess.
Life is unfair.
Yes, no, maybe. I don't know.
Oh, that's it, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they might be giants. They might be giants. Great song.
I didn't like really any of those commercials. Some of those they were showing before the Super Bowl even was on.
Yeah, like I didn't see Mr. Peanut, and I knew they were talking about that one.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah. Charlie Day for Tide Pods.
I missed that one. I missed a couple of them. I'm not going to lie, I did really sleep throughout it because I was like, this is so boring.
Charlie Day did this whole thing with Tide Pods that he was jumping into other commercials for Bud Light.
I did see that. Yeah.
Yeah. And he wound up with Gal Gadot in their Wonder Woman costume and say we're going to do this later. And he's like, later. And you have one of those.
Yeah. And then they're all old and shit. Yeah, I remember that.
Well, the Charlie Day freak out, basically.
Everyone voted at my house and they liked the T-Mobile one with Anthony Anderson, and I was like, yeah, it was good, but it was funny, but you know, it was too family oriented, I guess.
Yeah. Well, I also like the Rick and Morty Pringles commercial.
Yeah, that was funny too. Yeah. And it was weird. Did you notice their eyes weren't so squiggly like they normally are?
Mm-hmm. I did not notice that.
Is there a reason for that? Is there a reason for that?
Yeah, just their art style is their pupils of their eyes are really squiggly. So okay, somebody's
it's got to be
cooking in a microwave.
It's got to be BDism. No, that was me warming up the air fryer.
Can we put him on video or something? Because I need to see what he's doing now. I'm tired of sitting around hearing this.
No, get him a GoPro.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Well, I know what I'm buying tomorrow.
Yeah.
Well, I have a lot of traffic coming in and out of my kitchen. So,
That's when you kick them out. That's when you wave the gun around, and then they'll all leave.
Oh, I thought you meant
to make an example out of one of them.
And then they're going to take us seriously. Kill one.
What is this notification?
What the fuck?
ATF wants to know your location.
Oh, shit. No.
Said, wave the gun around. ATF wants to know your location.
That was bad because I totally like spilled all my coffee on me, dicks. Oh, man. All right. Well, I guess we should get this going then, huh?
Did you get that text I sent you about T-shirt with Trump because he tweeted the wrong fucking state?
No, what was this?
Yeah, good one, guy.
So after the Super Bowl, Trump tweeted, you make us proud and you've represented the great state of Kansas. He tweeted it and then deleted it because someone told him that Kansas City was in Missouri. So even Senator McCaskill tweeted back calling him an idiot or something like that.
Which is rich coming from McCaskill, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
To be fair, unless you knew, and then like maybe actually went to school, you would know that Kansas City is in Missouri.
Jeez.
Well, there's two of them.
There is two.
Yeah, like St. Louis.
Easy mistake.
Yeah, rookie mistake. All right, here we go. I'm sorry, what?
I always think Indiana and Ohio's up or below, not to our west. So I mean, to be fair, I'm bad at geography, but I'm not the president of the United States. So
you could be.
Oh, I'm sorry, United States of America. If I was your president, I'm sorry. I'd hopefully be nice, but I'm
vote sorry. For Frasley.
That's an easy job, man.
Frasley 2020. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. See, we already got Travis for our next senator. Now we need our president.
Absolutely.
Yep. Did I ever send you those fries? Those that picture of Travis becoming a senator?
No.
All right, I'll have to find that real quick and put it out there. Don't put it on the show though.
So, okay.
Yeah, too.
But because it has his family in it. But all right. So while we do that, I'm going to press the button, and we'll get started with B-Dism. Ready?
Go.
Let's go.
Hi, this is B-Dism, and this is Treat Yourself.
I don't hear it. What are we doing?
It's on his end. You can't hear it.
Yeah. So when you hear me say press the button, just give me like 10 seconds, okay?
Today is leg quarters. Doing some clearing out of the freezer. Got some leg quarters. Got my air fryer going. About to get it in. Secondly, I got some muffins that I'm going to be making. Trying to be healthy.
Oh, so do these will you be... know the muffin man?
Oh, yeah. Some healthy muffins. Which, all recipes and anything that I've cooked, you can find on my Instagram page at B-Dism.
Ooh, we got an Instagram page now. Hell yeah.
At B-Dism. So requests, I accept all friend requests or follow requests, but please, you're more than welcome to see the menu, as I call it.
I want your healthy muffins.
How much for feet pics?
That didn't come out right, Fred. How much for feet pics? Fraz, that didn't come out right, man. You got me worried, bro.
How much for feet pics?
That was not me. That was Norco asking that.
No, that wasn't me.
That was Travis.
That was Travis. I'm sorry.
Cue my outro.
This has been a treat yourself update.
Did you see your text yet, Fraz?
Oh, not.
Look at the text. Nice. Oh.
Somebody better call my mama.
Yeah. Yeah, look at this. It feels so weird. Look at this. It feels like I have a stroke. Because, like, my lip and everything right here is kind of droopy. It's a rubber face. Okay.
How long were you in surgery?
Oh, about an hour and a half, I think.
What'd you
I don't
do,
know.
Man?
I fell asleep during it. So
have some wisdom tooth teeth taken out or something?
No. I had two root canals done. Mm-hmm. And then they put the partials on there, and I got to go back and get the two things. So when they juice me up, the worst thing, in my opinion, in the whole dentist thing, is that needle they put in for the Novocaine. Ugh.
Yeah.
That's the worst.
Yeah, it's huge, and, like, you can feel, like, the metal, again, like, go through your, like... Yeah. Musculoskeletal system.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to puncture through the skeleton. Yeah, through my, yeah. And, but once it was all numbed out, I passed out. They laid me down. I was just out. It was awesome. Had my headphones on, just chilling.
Well, that drill is calming. It is. What? I've had so much dental work done. Yeah, it's calming.
I'm with you, man. Falling asleep is cool.
Now, I woke up a couple times and the smell was so horrible.
Oh, yeah, burning teeth. That damn drill.
Why, you guys don't like that? I love that smell.
Oh, me too.
Smell of burning teeth.
And I love the pain. I love that pain.
I thank God I had only 1 second of pain. And that was after they got done, the guy pressed on something and it hurt. And I, like, kind of looked up at him from, like, in the chair. And he looked down at me. And then he looked back up, and then I just kind of closed my eyes and went back to bed because I was like, eh. Did you say prostate?
Bed? Yeah, your prostate? Ow.
No.
Never mind.
No, but they're good dentists. And the dental assistant lady, she's really cool. She's kind of attractive. She's like the soccer mom, you know. And she was showing me her more. Little poor bulldog. He was having paw issues, and I was like, aw. Yeah.